Hello everyone, my name is Garrett Oakamber, and welcome back to 7 Days to Die. This is Alpha 12, and I'm going to be resuming my survival series on this, which I did not... Ooh, that didn't do anything. Okay. I didn't mean to take such a long vacation from the game, but as I've stated in past videos, it's very nice to be able to come back when things happen, and it puts a refreshing sort of... Or puts a refreshing sort of spin on the game when everything is brand new and exciting, and you know, this is Alpha 12. This game is just, it's really progressing with good distance. Well, I shouldn't be wasting all this ammunition here, but I figured, why the hell not? Nothing behind me, is there? Zombies are infamous for just sneaking up behind you. You'd think something that has no real self-awareness wouldn't be that sneaky, but they are. So we're going to be going up the hill here and seeing what we can see and see if we can survive. I'd like to survive. That might be a challenge with all the bears and other things in the wilderness here. So what I've got in my inventory is just a standard sort of starting kit. I've even got a wooden bow here. But that doesn't guarantee success, as we know from times past. Apparently can't break grass with that. We're gonna use our torch to do that. Because I can do that. We need to make an axe. Prepare tool is pretty nice, but it's not gonna do us any good in the long run. Smack that grass, yeah. There's a bunny over there. I haven't seen one of those in a while. Hello, bunny. It's kind of weird going back into 7 Days to Die after playing Ark for so long. I mean, I've literally been grinding hours on Ark. It's a very grindy game, but it's a very refreshingly fun game. It'd probably be a good idea to make... Well, I didn't mean to make that many, but whatever. That didn't work out the way it should have. Hi. Can I break this tree with a shotgun? Goodbye, tree. Good night. Okay, so you can. It's good to know. Hi. Nothing coming up behind me? Okay. Oh, the satisfying sound of shotgun shots. Yeah, hit that building. Oh yeah, kill the zombie with it. That is just badass. See, that is how you do this. That is how you do this. When you make a zombie game, have the environment play an important role in how you can take out zombies or how, you know, things go. And if you can just destroy a zombie with a single tree, it's just, it's such a meaningless little thing, but it's so cool. No, oh, you're on fire. Don't touch me, please. I want you to be on fire. My love for you is burning. You too, Tubby. Nah, never mind. You're gonna get... Oh, hi. You're gonna get pellets to the face. Bam! Okay. I was just like, why am I walking so slow? And then I realized I had fallen earlier, and that's not very good. It's not good for my health. Actually wounded. So I'm gonna take some painkillers. And those should help us in the long run. I would like that. Thank you. Leather gloves? Okay. Works. Okay. And now that I know it, I can toss it, because I will not need it. Or will I? I don't think I need it. I think I know everything I need to know about leather gloves. Do you know everything you need to know about leather gloves? I don't. Ah, come on, don't do that. Game, that's not cool. It's being weird. Okay. I have no idea how I'm going to... Actually, I think I can make an axe right now. Yeah, I can make an axe, right? No, I need stone. Shit. Why don't I have any stone? I've been only just sitting here talking to myself for, what, how long? Oh, you can find those! Those are so cool! Okay, bows, even better now. See, I don't know if that goes with crossbow bolts. I really don't know if crossbow bolts can be made of iron or whatever. That makes sense, since you can do it with bows. Or if they're just going to do away with the crossbow. I hope they don't do away with the crossbow, because it's still a very different kind of weapon. That is gross. He's gross. All meaty and disgusting. You have enough food to slowly heal. Thank you. Okay, we're not going to break that anytime soon. Let's eat and drink some water, because I've been running around all day. I'd like to get inside here. This is an entire town, actually, which is good. But I'd like to get in there. Oh, that's... Okay, that's really awesome. I didn't notice that. So I just click on it, and it will automatically allot items, even if I haven't made it already. Screw it. I'm going to waste some shells on these guys. I don't want to have to. No, at the same time, I really don't want to have to. Hi. Yeah, you're on fire. Oh. Okay, he's done. Well done. No! No, no, no! No, no! Oh, shit. One more hit and I'm done. My soul. And I won't be cooked. My goose is cooked. This is bad. This is not a good way to start this. And every shot just brings in more zombies. I'm not gonna have any shots left. I like to use that when I'm bleeding. Okay. I really want to get inside this building. But it's not gonna happen. So we're gonna just... What the hell? Okay, everything looks like a bag now when it's on the ground. I guess that helps, server lag. Kind of sad, though. You won't see those comical items just floating on the ground anymore. Ah, it's a water tower. And there's a house next to it. This would be a really good spot to have a house. Because that does have water in it, believe it or not. And, yeah. And this building here should be easily secured. We're gonna burn the zombie down. They made combat so difficult. I mean, it's been difficult for a while. Ow. Come on, that's not cool. Don't do this. Oh, that barrel would be so nice. I might have to spend some bullets to do something here. Hate to waste all my bullets, because they're very, very valuable. I don't want to have to. Come on, game. Ow. Nope. No, 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 no. No, this is not good. Okay, I've got a bow with some arrows. Made them on the fly here. Just checking behind me, doing my due diligence here. Making sure nothing's behind me. Glad I hit you, but I'm trying to hit the one in front of me. First rule of killing zombies in a line, always go for the zombie in front of you. And then he does a little jazz dance there as he goes down. Oh shit, that's a bear. Thank God they don't have a high aggro radius. You have to get really close to them to piss them off. Which is fortunate. I just took the liberty of taking the barrel of explosive fuel away from the house. As easy as it would be to get inside, I did not want to sully the mood. I didn't need to kill that one, but... Can I make more of these? I need, more feathers. Which is not going to be easy to find in my current predicament, but I've got all day to do it, and then I can loot the house if I'm successful. If I'm not, I will die at night. And this will be a very unfortunate turn of events, but hey, every episode is different. Every episode has successes and immediate, terrible failures. Just had an idea. I don't know how many hits it's gonna take, but I could destroy one of these trees and hit the zombies with it if I really need to. Because now trees are useful, but I'm not gonna resort to that if I don't need to. Currently, as it stands, heard that bear. I don't know where it is. Currently, as it stands, I can't afford to just waste my bullets like I was doing earlier. I was just like, hey, yeah, I got bullets, let's use them. And now I'm suddenly more conscious of the fact that I don't have many. I say bullets, I mean shotgun shells. Whatever, they're a thing that you shoot things with. I'm gonna try to burn you to death. Yeah, you don't want it to burn, apparently. I just think it's really random when you burn them. Oh, there you go. He's on fire. Yeah, it's just a random chance in hell. Okay, I'm glad you're down. Do you have anything of use on you? Maybe some more shotgun shells, maybe? Possibly? No, he's got feathers, though. And that's actually good. Okay. Means we can take care of more of these zombies if we really need to, which we will need to. They don't see me at the moment, so this means I can possibly break the door. I don't want to. It's a scrap metal door. It's kind of nice. That's going to take me a while to get through. We'll see what I can do. I don't want to resort to blasting in a house, as it's also going to prevent me from... it's going to make the house weaker. I'm gonna have to fix it. It might destroy something on the other side. That's a pretty risky situation. This door is flimsy enough that I can break it, and that is a good thing. So we are now through the door. And hopefully nothing will come this way. Bunny, don't go in here. I love you, Bunny, but please don't go in here. Oh god, this is creepy as hell. Oh, this is like something out of The Walking Dead. Can I go under that? No, I can't. Obviously I can't go under that. Game's very selective right now about what you can and can't go under. Hey, this door works, though. What the hell? Oh, I almost had a heart attack. I was like, is that like an egg or something? This is cute. Under the stairs there. I don't want to be detected, but I don't have much of a choice here. I gotta break this. I hate to do it. Gotta do it. Can't go through. Cabinet. That's a cabinet. Glass in that. These ones can't open. Okay, that's cool. What's up here? So I have taken the upstairs of this building, and I've turned it into my own. I am going to put a door down in the front, as that would be very beneficial to my survival. And just upgrading it a little bit will make all the difference in the world. And I can actually turn these into scrap, which is very useful. There we go. Going outside should not be too much of an issue right now. But I have to be mindful about bears. Bears will be a problem for me no matter what. Ooh, right there. Yeah, there's a bear. Killing a bear, though, would be a very nice thing to do. And this is probably one of those extreme cases where using a gun is a good thing. Or an invisible gun. And I'm being attacked. Okay. That's not good. Oh, I forgot I couldn't run. Did he just bleed to death? Did. Okay. That works. I didn't know that was a thing. Unless that bunny rabbit killed him, but fuck if I know. There's your pig. Your Mr. Pig. I'm not gonna kill you. I could very easily do it, but I just don't want to do it. I don't need to. I killed a bear. I killed a bear. Not with my bare hands. That would have been even better.
Did you kill a bear with my bare hands?
This bunny, however, is proving to be a very delicious... if not frustrating... Okay, he's gone. And there's a zombie here. Hi. Hi, zombie. Hey, zombie. What are you up to? Surprise, those gunshots didn't attract more zombies. Whoops. Come on. Yeah. Okay, that's a glitch. Come on, game. Okay, come on, game. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for allowing me to kill that zombie. Because that did not seem like a very fair thing you were throwing my way. Hi. Hi. Hey, can you get on the ground? Yeah, thank you. Okay, that definitely hit you, but... There we go. There's yet another zombie right here. Hello. Goodbye. I shoot you some more. Don't you do that zigzag shit to me. You're not supposed to have a survival instinct. Oh my god. Wasted so many arrows on them. Oh, this isn't cool at all. Come on. God, the axe is faster than it used to be. Axe used to be like, oh god, I'm never gonna kill this thing, and now it's like, yeah, axe. Axe party, don't you dare smack me. Axe. Oh, it doesn't stagger them that much. Oh god, oh. It's panicking there. Melee combat is still something to be desired, I mean. But it will be there. It'll get there eventually. We'll be able to see a fully functional, thingamaburb. Okay, so I'm gonna go make a fire upstairs, put my meat on there. I probably stink to high heavens, as my game is telling me. And I need to get some water. So that'll be a trip. Okay, well, the really sucky part... that isn't it. The really sucky part is that I need to go to that well here. Water tower, and see if I can actually get the water without having to break anything, which may or may not be possible at this point. So we're gonna find out. Looks like I'm gonna have to break something to get in. If I do it wrong, I'm gonna have a mess. Glue. Okay. Oh, we're making arts and crafts here? What is this? Oh, please don't knock me off. Hello, Mr. Bear. I heard you. You sound really close, even though you're not. Okay. That's concerning.
Oh my god, it's gonna take forever.
I see the water, though. I see the water. I'm determined. I'm determined to get that liquid deliciousness. It's probably gonna come pouring out, isn't it? Yeah, it's probably gonna come spilling out and causing all kinds of problems. Nope. No, it did not. Okay. What don't I need? How about, you? Oh, it did spill out. Okay. Cool. Yeah. And it destroyed the wood railing. Awesome. Ow. Sprained. Okay, it's only sprained. That's good. That's good. That's good. I kinda need metal now, which... Oh no, the ladder... No... Well, at least the water's down here, right? Okay, I need another axe, because I can't actually do anything with the water. Shit. I can't do anything with the water that I have just yet, because I don't have a pot. So in order to get a pot, I need to make another axe, because this axe isn't going to survive. Now, why do I need an axe to make a pot? I need the axe to break the rocks. And... it's such a stupid little dance here. I need the axe to break the rocks, to get the metal, to make myself a pot, which... is still just, it's such a redundant thing to say, but that's what I need. I need all that stuff to do these things, and without one or two of them, I can't do anything. We're going to put that away, because that's dangerous. Let me quickly make the axe. Get some more wood. Why not? I got duct tape. Yay, duct tape. Oh, you can turn duct tape into cloth fragments. Let's do it. Yay, I got cloth fragments, which at this point I don't really think I need, but whatever. Now that I've got an extra axe, I can then... Oh god, I'm about to... I'm really thirsty too. This is not good. I then need to... Wait, I can't even make a pot because I need a freaking furnace. God damn it. I'm gonna die. I need the water. I need it. Oh, that didn't sound good. I appear to be okay, but that did not sound good at all. Nightfall's gonna be on us. I'm gonna destroy this. Why? No. No, don't make me do it. Why? Good news is that bear over there is actually going to attract a lot of attention. And in a good way, because he'll actually kill zombies. Bad news is there will be zombies around here. I don't very much enjoy that fact. Okay. Boarding up for the night. I like this side here. It's double boarded up. Leaving some of the windows open for light. I currently don't have the luxury of torches. I like the natural lighting in this game a lot. I didn't want to waste metal, but why not? Fuck. Okay. Okay, we're good. We're good. It's dark. Well, it's getting dark. It's the onset of night. You can hear crickets. Pretty soon it's going to get frightening. And I might start shitting myself. Yeah, that's what I might do. I might start shitting myself all over the place. And this is why I love zombie games. Especially good ones. 7 Days to Die is just getting there. It's just... I mean, it's been a good game. But what I mean is it's getting to that point that only the imagination can truly capture. And it's the small moments like this that make this game such a good buy. So if you've never actually considered buying the game... and you've watched my videos, take it from me. I think it's on that way to becoming one of the greatest zombie games of all time, if it isn't already. And someday, you know, it'll probably be just as big in our minds as, that's gross. Can I make sounds? Yeah, it made a sound when I walked near him. That's gross. But yeah, it's gonna be as big in our minds as, like... World War Z and freaking Left 4 Dead and things like that. It's just so creepy and so good. So I'm going to end this episode here, and I'm hoping you guys are enjoying the series so far, and let me know what you think about the update. You know, do you think it's any good? Do you like it so far? I like it, but I want to hear from you. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next episode of 7 Days to Die.